Hi, I'm Michael Prettyman, one of your pastors here at Grace Works Church in Chattanooga, Tennessee. Here are some things going on at Grace Works Church starting with Sunday, December the 31st, New Year's Eve, moving backwards to today. On Sunday, December the 31st, we will be having our Remember the Saints service where we recognize church members and immediate family members of church members who passed away in the year 2023 by lighting a candle in their remembrance. On Sunday, December the 24th, Christmas Eve, we will be having two identical Christmas Eve services. One of the services will be held at our regular 10:30 a.m. time, and the other service will be held at 5 p.m. The service will be about 35 to 45 minutes and will include music, communion, scripture reading, and candle lighting, as well as some other elements. This Sunday, we'll be having some musical performances from our Grace Kids and Grace Crew in our morning service. This afternoon at 4 p.m., we'll be having a time of Christmas music. There'll be choir, quartet, duets, handbells, congregational music, and an instrument ensemble. To our Peru mission team, welcome home. Thank you, Grace Works Church, for your financial donations, as we were able to raise $2,877 for Bundles of Love. In the service this morning, the mission team will be sharing some of their experiences with us from their mission trip. Thank you again for joining us this morning, and I hope that you have a great day. Take care. Bye-bye. All right. Well, we're going to take time this morning. If you've been coming, if you're here for the first time in the last couple of weeks, this is Advent number 3, and we're going to be doing our Advent candle lighting. So I'm going to ask Terry and Austin, I swapped things around a little bit there, so I'm going to get y'all to come on up and do this, and they're going to do our candle lighting this morning. That'll work.
The third candle symbolizes joy and is called the shepherd's candle. To the shepherd's great joy, the angels announce that Jesus came for humble, unimportant people like them too. In liturgy, the color rose signifies joy. The third Sunday of Advent, we are invited to reflect on the joy we have access to because of our faith in Jesus. One of the defining characteristics of Christ's followers is their joyful demeanor. Let's not allow the struggles of this year to steal from the great joy we have because of Jesus. This Sunday, we are reminded to rejoice for the good news. Jesus came and died so that we may live forever with Him. Luke 2, 8 through 14.
And as he's lighting the candles here, and he's lighting the joy candle, will y'all sing this with me?
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing. Let heaven and nature sing. Let heaven and
Good morning. Glad that you are here this morning. Welcome to Grace Works Church, and I'll welcome everybody here again in just a moment. But this morning, we're going to get started out with the quartet singing this morning, which is now a quartet minus one, or a trio, because the bass this morning, Usually, you know, they wake up with a frog in your foot of your base. Well, he woke up without the frog. He woke up with nothing. So he's not here this morning. So for all of you who like to sing bass, this is a really good bass song. And so we need our bass singers to chime in and sing with these guys as they sing Beautiful Star of Bethlehem.
Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shining afar through shadows dim, giving a light for those who long have gone, and guiding the wise men on their way unto the place where Jesus lay. Beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on. Oh, beautiful star.
Star of Bethlehem,
shine upon us until the glory, glory dawn. Oh, give us the light to light the way into the land of perfect day. Beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on. Oh, beautiful star, the hope of rest for the redeemed, the good and blessed. Yonder in glory when the crown is won. For Jesus is now the star divine, brighter and brighter he will shine. Beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on. Oh, beautiful star of Bethlehem, shining with your
give him the light to light the way into the land of perfect.
No.
That's not right.
Beautiful star of Bethlehem, shine on.
We missed the
bass. Hey,
the bass.
That was nice recovery. Mike, it should make you feel good if you're watching online. They can't do it without you, man. They need the anchor here. Well, thank you all for singing this morning, guys. And this afternoon, by the way, we have a Sunday afternoon Christmas. We're going to be having a singing happening this afternoon, Christmas songs. And we'll do that one again this afternoon. And we'll try to maybe get that one right this time. But thank you guys for doing that this morning. And so, what's that? You're saying they didn't do nice? No, I'm kidding. I'm messing with you. But thank you all for being here this morning, and welcome to our Facebook Live audience who is watching online. And it's kind of a dreary day here in Chattanooga, Tennessee. It's a nice, typical, nice December day in Chattanooga, Tennessee. It's kind of foggy and everything out, but we're inside in this beautiful sanctuary with our Christmas decorations around. The heat's running. It's all good in here. We're singing Christmas music, and we got Christmas music going again this afternoon. But I want you guys to go ahead and stand up right now and get out there in the aisles and find somebody that you normally don't find on a Sunday morning. Shake their hand this morning and tell them, welcome to Grace Works Church this morning.
Thank you.
Sing this with us.
Oh, come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of ages. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Now sing, choirs of angels.
Sing, choirs of angels, sing in exultation, or sing all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, glory in the
going to sing one more here, and you do the glory. You remember the glory? Okay, you got to get this part right. Here we go. Angels, we have heard on high.
Angels, we have heard on high. Sweetly singing o'er the plains and the mountains in reply.
Give the Lord a clap offering this morning. Thank you guys for singing with us this morning. you can go ahead and grab a seat right now. This morning, we got some extra things going on here because I've got some of the Grace kids and some of the Grace crew in here. And we didn't do, some years we do plays, some years we do little Christmas musicals and things. And this year, we just had the kids coming up and doing some songs for us. And I'm going to start out with the Grace kids first, singing a song that Jan found for us. And they do really good back there in the music room. We'll see what they do in here. You know, the adults are going to do all our motions, but we'll see if we can get the Grace kids to come up here. The name of this song is called Baby Jesus, We Love You. So we'll get them in place here. And then here, you can come right over here. Come on down this way just a little bit. You can stand right here. Come right there. Oh, that'll work. And are we good? I want to make sure all these guys get on camera here. All right. Okay. You guys ready for this? Go ahead, Miss Jackie, when you're ready. Thank you, Grace kids. Well, I think I have McKenna. McKenna's going to come up and she's going to play for us a song. By the way, we will be singing this song as a congregational on at our Christmas Eve services. I'll put a little plug in there. We're having one at 10:30 a.m. and one at 5 p.m. So be there. But so we'll be singing this as a congregational piece, but McKenna's going to be playing it for us on saxophone today. if you, all of our Grace kids and Grace crew, they do a lot of different things. If you watch online, I know I follow Jennifer on Facebook, and she's been dancing all week this week, so doing Christmas recitals with that and everything, so multi-talented. And I've asked, here we go, Caroline. Caroline's going to come up and play for us on the keyboard. I'm going to try to get this out of the way so you guys can see her pretty well. And she's going to play a couple of pieces for us this morning. Thank you, Caroline. And like I say, all of our kids, they have multi-talents that they do. Caroline also, I know she was running cross-country, and this year she's doing cheerleading, right? So, yeah. So thank you. And Miss Kylie, coming up here, she's going to sing a song for us that I think some of you guys know, and I'm going to sing along with her. And can they sing along with us if they know it? Okay, all right. Y'all can sing with us if you know this song. It's called All Is Well. Let's sing this together.
All is well. All is well. Angels and men rejoice. For tonight,
And if I had to list all the accolades of Kylie, we would be here till 11:30. She is a state champion and so many champion over and over and over and over in gymnastics. So she's fantastic. Maybe one day I'll get her to do a little flip up here on the stage or something like that. So she's not shy. She'd do that. So. Well, thank you, Grace Kids. And if you guys need to go out, Grace Kids or Grace Crew, y'all can go on out at this time. We're going to take time right now as these guys are scooting out. And thank you guys again for being in here with us this morning. So, yeah, give them a hand as they go out. Appreciate you guys. And so much appreciate our workers who work with them every week. They do a great job. And but right now, it's just a time, if you're visiting with us, for the first time, this is the first time you're hearing it. If you're here regularly, you're like, get on with it, Michael. You say this all the time. But this is our, what I have written in the service order as the prayer chorus. And it's just a time where we can stop and we can pray and we can thank the Lord for something this morning. I will be the first to admit that a lot of times I'll go to the Lord and I'll ask Him for things and ask and ask and ask and not maybe go back and thank so much, not being thankful or not being grateful. And we have so much to be grateful for. You remember the story when Jesus healed the 10 lepers, and He said for them to go to the high priest, I guess, at that time, and He would say that you're healed, you're clean, and you can re-enter society. If you remember, He healed 10 guys, and one of them came back and thanked Jesus for healing him. So maybe we can up the percentages a little bit and be more thankful for everything we have. So right now, if you just take a moment to bow your heads and close your eyes and thank the Lord for something this morning, we're going to sing just one more song here in a moment, and then we're going to turn it over to Tony and the mission team, but don't miss this opportunity right now. Say it with me.
Emmanuel, His name is called Emmanuel. He's God.
God, we thank You for this season and what it means to us as Christians. And God, we thank You for all the fun celebrations we're able to have and the beautiful decorations and everything that goes on in this time of year. But God, we are thankful for the greatest gift of all time that You gave us in Jesus Christ. So I speak on behalf of everyone in this room right now, God, when I tell You that we love You and we thank You. We thank You for that gift. It is in Jesus' name we pray all these things. Amen.
Amen. Good morning, everyone. It's so good to be back with you. I've been out for 2 weeks. Did you miss me? Well, Lana is over here coughing on the side, but I've got to talk to Bill Owens and find out what he did while I was gone to have people clap. No, it is good to be back. Missed the last 2 weeks on a mission trip in Peru. And just such a blessing to be able to come back. It's a blessing to go, but a blessing to come back. And I want to say thank you to our Grace Crew. That's our youth group, Grace Crew. Justin Burney sitting over here with them. And we thank you for your leadership in worship this morning. And appreciative of Glenda Hardy and Jan Moses and their role they play in our Grace Kids Children's Ministry. This morning, I want us to look just a second. Don't worry, I'm not going to preach. But I want to share a passage of Scripture that goes with our Advent lighting. Luke chapter 2, the gospel account Luke has of the birth of Jesus. In Luke chapter 2, verses 8 and following, listen to these words, the announcement of the angels. In the same region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news. Good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloth, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." And when the angels went away from them into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying they had been told them concerning the child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. Generally speaking, a question that starts with, did you hear? Did you see? Generally, when a question begins like that, it's followed by bad news. Did you hear? Did you see? We hear enough bad news, don't we? How many of you are tired of bad news? We need to hear some good news. What was the angel's greeting? "Fear not, behold, I bring you good news." Good news of great joy, and it's for everybody. And the good news is, God, out of his great love for sinful man, has sent his Son. Sent him to be our Savior. That's good news. Last week, or week before last, when we were in Peru, we went to share the good news. The good news, the simple news, God loves you. Whether it's English or Spanish, the good news is the same. God loves you. I want to ask our mission team, those that participated, to join me up here. We're going to take a few minutes to share testimony of our experience and get everybody to come up here. I know we have one team member missing. In our mission trip to Peru, we had the opportunity to partner with AMG International. It's a ministry located, centered here in Chattanooga, a ministry of the gospel to the world. And we participated in distributing gifts to children in the children's centers there, four different centers in Lima and Juarez and Yungar. And we presented these gifts as a result of your giving to Bundles of Love. The month of November, we collected offering. And as said earlier, over $2,800 was collected by Grace Works Church. Thank you so much. The items, the gifts these children received were necessity type items. A blanket, a sheet for their bed. Things that we may not give our kids for Christmas. But they were overjoyed to receive those. And we were able to share, spend time with them playing games, board games, playing soccer or attempting to play soccer, sharing testimony. And you went with us. Your prayers, your financial support, these that represent Grace Works. And I've asked them to come and share one of their highlights for the week. I've already found any of these could stand here and speak for 30 minutes or more, sharing about what God showed them in their experience. But I've just asked them to find one thing that they would like to hold on to remember. Dorothy True was one of our team members, and Dorothy is homesick and at home sick, not homesick. But if you didn't get sick when you're in Peru, you picked it up when you got home. So we're all kind of struggling, trying to heal up, and you may hear a little bit. But this is a picture of Dorothy. And Dorothy, she sent me her testimony as a email, just said, hey, would you look at this and read this, make sure it makes sense. And I guess it's a blessing, because we didn't know she wouldn't be here. So I want to read to you the email she sent me of her testimony. Dorothy says, the true test in your faith is even when you don't understand anything at all, you still trust God. I still don't know why I decided to go to Peru. I only know that God put it on my heart. And as many times that I wanted to back out, God told me that I had to go. I trusted God. I still don't know how God used me or what my gifts are or if I even touched anyone's heart while I was there. But I do know that I listened to and followed someone greater than all of us. I trusted God. Every night at dinner, we would each talk about our highs and lows of the day we experienced. And as a whole, two memories keep coming back to me that touch me. On Wednesday and Thursday of the last week, we got to visit the same center 2 days in a row. I met a 9-year-old named Camilla. For some reason, she took me under her wing. Each day, she would take me by the hand and take me to her 5-year-old sister, Mia. We would play board games meant for 3 to 5-year-olds to communicate. She taught me how to count to 6 in Spanish by rolling dice. It's still the only Spanish I really know. The kids were so beautiful. They all had this jet black hair and jet black eyes with jet black long eyelashes that would just stare into your soul. I will never forget them. The AMG families, workers, volunteers I met in my week in Peru were the most selfless, beautiful people I've ever met in my life. They've devoted their lives not only to God, but to these children. They make sure that the children at the centers who have absolutely nothing are provided for with much love and sometimes their only meal for the day. But most importantly, they were teaching them about Jesus and that Jesus loves them. They're teaching them about faith and that when they don't understand anything else, that the world has given them to still and always trust God. I would say for Dorothy, God did use her. And it was amazing in some of the images and pictures you may see of Dorothy and having kids surround her. And her presence says, God loves you. And that's the reason we went, to say, God loves you. I'm going to turn, and Susan, you get to be first, and then Bob. And then Joe, and then Mark, and then Jimmy. Can y'all remember that order? Do we need to rearrange everybody? We've lived together for over a week, so you'll see how flexible we are.
Thank you, Tony. So I will say that going on the mission trip has been something Bob and I had talked about and thought about for many years. Due to family commitments, we had not been able to leave the country. So this was our very first mission trip. Again, when the mission trip was first mentioned here, we gave it no further thought because we felt the timing just wasn't good. Then Tony texts Bob to inquire again about our interest in the trip. So as we thought about it, and as it stated in Isaiah 6:8, send me. And in 1 Peter 4:10, use the gifts that you have received to serve others. So we decided that the timing couldn't be any better than to go now and to cancel our plans that we had already made. I'll just say one thing. As you heard in Tony reading Dorothy's testimony for it, the trip was awesome. AMG, specifically Ken Ivins, planned and organized it very well. Plus, we just had a great team. There were 11 total of it, 11 total on the team, 7 here from Graceworks. So we did visit 4 child care centers, and they were amazing. Just to stand back and look at what they do, the staff there every day. I think one day we probably had over 120 children there at one time, and it was just incredible. The volunteers at each of the centers, they cook, they tutor, and they minister to the children. All of the children we encountered were very polite, and there were hugs, many hugs, multiple hugs from the same kids, and the children were all very appreciative of the gift they received. So as Tony mentioned, we were asked today to speak about one high from the trip. This was very hard to select just one, but my favorite was 2 girls. I believe that's them there. They were 12 years old, and we met at the Spiro Sodati Center in Lima. So at that center, we had the opportunity to visit the center 2 days. The first day, we had just gotten back from our bus trip off of the mountain in Juarez, and so it was just a play day. We had lots of Uno and other card games and other things, soccer and other things going on. So I quickly formed a bond with the 2 girls, and we exchanged English and Spanish names for articles of clothing, for jacket, shirt, socks, and shoes. The girls were so engaged in learning how to pronounce these in English, and then they came to me before they left that day, and we did a quick test, rundown on how well they remembered the English words. They did very well. Then the next day, on Thursday, they sought me out as soon as they got there. I was able to make sure that even though with the communication barrier of Spanish to English, that they knew that Jesus loved them. And I was able to present them with their gifts. What a blessing they were to me. So as we come back here, we are all glad to be back, but we will continue to pray for all the centers and the staff we visited as each one shared a list of their specific prayer requests with us. With that being said, I do want to wish Tony and Lana a happy 35th anniversary, wedding anniversary today.
Upon our arrival, we were tired, anxious, and immediately realized we were out of our element. We were going to be depending on the Lord, each other, and our host that would guide and translate for us for the week. Early on, walking with Tony, I realized I'm taking about 2.5 steps for each one of his. If you can imagine a swan and a little baby duck going across a pond, Tony, Bobby. That was about the pace I kept for the next 8 days. But we did great. Regarding our schedule and accommodations, our director, Ken Ivins, did an outstanding job. AMG, they have this down to a fine art. If you ever consider going on a mission trip, that's absolutely the route to go. They really just do a wonderful job. One of the things that quickly became one of my favorite parts was our group devotions. There are study guides with a central theme and verses that relate, and we would all do our homework and bring it back, and it was just amazing for 10 or 11 people to have the same verses and to come back and share those thoughts and learn from each other. Really enjoyed it. My initial prayer upon arrival was, Lord, keep us safe. And in his providence, he extended that protection to include bus rides, taxis, trains. If you can imagine Star Wars getting the contract to handle the traffic in Atlanta, that's what it's like to ride on a street in Peru, any street. Imagine Hamilton Place at 30 miles an hour. I don't mean bumper to bumper, gridlock. There's no gridlock. Everybody just wants to be first. It's just crazy. But it was fun to watch after a little while. After you realized you're not going to get hurt, it's not your car. And, just kind of roll with it. One of the highlights for the trip for me was spending time with a host pastor, his family, and our favorite translator, Julio. They were all just so kind and patient and was absolutely as interested in learning from us as we were them. Talking about culture, the different hobbies, work interests, just things like that. One of the thoughts I had while I was down there was heaven. Prior to Peru, I'd always thought of, you know, wanting to see my parents, grandparents, meeting, you know, missed loved ones. And now my thoughts, in addition to those, are to meet fellow believers from faraway places, to be in heaven and just to be with people that are like-minded. And that was the case for us. These people love the Lord just like we do. And it was just absolutely just a great experience to be with those folks. But the absolute best part was the children. Their smiles, their hugs were genuine. Their manners and politeness just kept me captivated. They were so appreciative of every little thing we did. There was some little bitty guys, and I was teaching them how to snap their fingers, and they were just, it was just so fun to be able to hug them and hold them, and they really, really appreciated it. Peru needs our prayers. AMG needs our support.
Good morning. This trip to Peru was a first for me. I've never been on a mission trip, but I went for a reason, to answer a question that I've had in my mind over the years as I heard about people going on mission trips. You go for a week, and I've always wondered how much can really be accomplished in a week. And so going, not knowing what to expect, I was surprised to see that going equipped wasn't really the point, is what they gave me. Going into these centers where these kids are really high risk at just living life and some of the challenges they have. We were there with the people that are there day by day, serving probably, for most of them, the only hot meal they get during the course of a day. And to be in the trenches with these folks, I think the best thing that we did was to be there to let them know that we appreciate what they're doing. They're guiding these kids on two battlefronts, spiritually for their relationship with God, but there's some social issues going on that are just intrinsic in the life they live. And halfway through the week, we were in a room, and I guess there was 40 or 50 kids in there, and I was really struck really deep, I mean almost to tears, about these kids, because without the work that Jose, who is the minister in Lima, in these centers, these kids would be consumed by the environment they live in. They wouldn't stand a chance. And I look forward to going back, because some of the relationships with Jose, Teresa, his wife, they've got four daughters that are professionals in various fields, but they're very intimately involved in these kids. Without this program, these kids wouldn't stand a chance. And oddly enough, a lot of what they face, we face in this country too. The father absent in the family, you know, the mother being the main person going on. Even these kids, for the most part, are sponsored. The sponsorship is really like a dollar a day, but the families, and most likely the mother, has to agree to keep these kids involved in a certain set of standards in order to be part of this program. I mean, they're doing great work down there, and there's even though there's a lot of uphill battles and a lot of kids are going to fall through those cracks, they're saving a lot of kids too. So, but I really enjoyed the experience and was very humbled by the kindness these folks showed to me. When I hit 10,000 feet, I knew I was there. and they were very, very concerned about my well-being. So, but yeah, I look forward to going back.
Oh, good morning, Grace Works. Yeah, I'd like to echo all the stories that they told. There were just so many remarkable things there. Tony's asked us to share one, but it's really hard to to just isolate one. For me, the biggest thing was just interacting with all the children, just the smiles on their faces, and these beautiful children, just the joy that was in their hearts. You know, we had the chance to come alongside to play some games, but to share with them and to share the love of Christ with them, that was just really special. But and in particular with the little ones, I mean, when just to get hugs from them, and just when they would hug you, they would hug you with their whole heart, and it would just something that would just absolutely melt you. And so just to share that love with them and to have that love shared in return, it was truly awesome. Also, just for the workers, the people that have volunteered there, just everything that they were pouring into the children, Joe did a wonderful job of kind of highlighting them, but just people that just wanted a better life for their kids and wanted to share the gospel with them, and just people that would work all night and then come to the centers and work all day with these children and just still had that joy within them. You know, people that were dealing with health issues that still would be there with the workers and then leave early to go get treatment, you know, to their scheduled treatment. So it was remarkable to come alongside them and to share the love of Christ, and just so thankful to all these people that went with the opportunity to interact with them, and it was truly just a wonderful trip. And thank you, GraceWorks, for your support.
There's not a whole lot more that I can add, but the first thing I want to say is thank you all for your prayers and really for the donations. Almost $3,000. That's a lot of money for people that don't have anything. Some of us are very privileged in what we have. Some of these kids have nothing, absolutely nothing. And it's just thank you all. I there's so many highs, like everybody said. I guess my biggest high is just being with these guys and Dorothy and the other four that was with us. It's a privilege to be able to do this. Some of us got very sick and was down for a day or two. I think every one of us got something, whether it was a head cold, elevation sickness, or whatever. But we fought through it too. We had a lot of fun. There were tears shed. There was frustrations. And the food was very good. Even those that ate the cooey, which is guinea pig. I didn't. But I just really want to thank you all, because if it wasn't for you all, we wouldn't be doing this. Just thank you very much.
I would encourage you, individuals on this team, to get with them and ask them to share about their experience, because they could share, obviously, a whole lot more about what they experienced, the highlights of the day, the one thing. I mean, it's so hard to find one thing. And for me, the highlight for mine, like Jimmy, was not necessarily me pouring into some kid or some kid doing something for me. It was the team that I was with. I had a conversation recently that we were talking about how you can inspire one another. And I was inspired as I looked at our team, as I saw all the kids grab Dorothy by the hand and take her upstairs to the game room and they played. I was inspired when I saw Joe Holland dancing with music. Yes, Joe, I saw this. I was inspired when I saw Bob Weeks play soccer. That guy is good. I was inspired when I saw a circle of girls gathered around Susan Weeks and they were exchanging. I was inspired when I see Big Mark and he's got these little kids hanging on him and he's throwing kids up in the air. I'm inspired when I see Jimmy Lail and he's mixing, he's using his best Spanish, which is terrible. But when I watched each one of them, I was inspired. I went to give and I gave to the kids there and to the volunteers. But I came home with these people. And these are the people I'll do life with. And so the high for me was that, being able to serve alongside of them. The passage of scripture I read from Luke chapter 2, the angels, they had the good news. They passed it to the shepherds. And the shepherds heard, but then they responded. They obeyed. They went. They saw Jesus. Does it stop there? No. Because if you keep reading that passage, it says they made known all that they had experienced. They made known. And those that heard, they wondered. The same thing is true for those who are Christians. You know the gospel, the good news. You've experienced it. You've responded. You placed your faith in it. But it doesn't stop there because you continue to share it. Some form or fashion. Jackie, did you share all those pictures? I haven't been watching the screen. I didn't know if you got to see some of the all the images. That's not the one I was looking for. But anyway, that guy got to go. But you see here images of our trip, and this is the kids receiving their gifts, a large group image. Here's Joe mixing it up with the kids. And you can see the places, the centers were real small and we were crowded. We got to serve the kids their meals, pass the plates to them. And there's the soccer field where we got to play, and it was a blessing. We all walked out of there not hurt. We shared a meal in home, and that meal, yes, we had fried guinea pig. And I don't know, we may have edited that picture, taken that picture out, because it's just like chicken, like everything else. But we had the opportunity, in spite of the cultural differences, to interact and share God's love. You see here, this is a stairway going up, and that's... We went up those stairs, and it took a while because of just the altitude involved. And you see images of where the people of Lima, Juarez, Yungar live. There's fried chicken and guinea pig to the left there. And one of Bob's highlights, which is one of mine, is when we sat down together and opened God's Word and spent time before we ever did anything that day. Today's a different kind of service. It's the Christmas season, and it's not your typical worship service. And I want you to consider the idea of the good news. You know the good news. You've experienced the good news. Will you share the good news? May God place on each one of our hearts someone that needs to know God loves them, whether it's another believer or whether it's someone that doesn't know Christ. This time we're going to sing together, and we're going to sing a song of worship and adoration. And Michael's going to come and lead us. And I don't know how you need to respond to our gathering here, but nothing else, sing and worship and praise the Lord who has given us good news to share. Would you stand and let's worship in song and prayer and commitment.
Sing this with me.
Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him. Oh, come, let us adore Him, Christ the Lord.
For He alone.
So worthy.
Ken Ivins, are you back there? You are, aren't you? Well, come on up here. Hurry up. I know you're quicker, a lot quicker than I am. You heard us mention Ken Ivins. Ken is part of the EMG ministry, and this is my brother in Christ, and love this guy. He and I have traveled quite a bit, many miles together, and you're going to get to pray in just a second.
Awesome.
You can do that to a brother. You just say, hey, you're going to pray. But you heard Ken's name mentioned. Ken was our team leader from AMG, and he led the team last year from Grace Works to Peru. And then in 2019, he led the team to Athens, Greece. And so he comes representing AMG, but also representing Kingdom of God. And I appreciate you so much. Love you, brother. And I know the team as well has that respect for you. And if you want to know anything about AMG, this is a man to speak with. He's got his wife, Dee, back there. And Dee, thank you so much for loaning him for a week to hang out with us and lead us. I know how important she is to you and to us as well. But Ken, I'm going to ask you to voice our prayer, and then Michael, you can conclude with any announcements. Thank you, brother.
Thank you. I just want to say it was a privilege. I do want to say quickly before I pray. Mark's like, just pray, Ken. He asked you to pray, just pray. But I do want to say it was a privilege traveling with the people like Mark and the ones who are a little bit older, Mr. Joe, kind of one of our older people on our team. But I just want to say, I want to encourage you guys, if you ever had the opportunity to go, what a great experience it was. You guys, your team represented your church well. I just loved working with them, serving with them, learning from them, seeing them in ministry. And I was encouraged. This was my sixth trip, actually, with Tony. And so it was a pleasure seeing him as he continues to lead. Love your people. Love your church. Thank you for allowing us to be here today. Let me pray with you if we can. Father God, I just thank you so much for the great things we heard today. God, I thank you for from the music and the children and the things that they did. And they performed for your honor and your glory. Lord, we just enjoyed that. And just thank you so much for that. Lord, as we heard the testimonies of those that went and served, Lord, I just thank you so much that their service is not just something that happens somewhere else in the world, but God, it happens right here in Chattanooga. And I pray that God, each and every one of us will be challenged, as we were challenged today, to take your word, the gospel that we've received, what little we understand, or what maybe for those that have been saved for a long time, what great parts we understand, and take that information and share it with those around us. God, the world here in Chattanooga and around the world needs to know about the best news, the greatest news, the good news of Jesus Christ and what he's done for us. Thank you so much for coming to this earth as a baby. Thank you for living a perfect life on our behalf. Thank you for dying in our stead, raising again 3 days later, showing us you have power over death and sin, and then God giving us your righteousness as we just embrace that gift. Lord, help us to be all about that as we serve you today. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Ken. Hey, and guys, this afternoon, 4 p.m., if you want some Christmas music, come on back, because we're going to be doing a lot of Christmas music. There's going to be handbells. There's going to be a choir. There's going to be a quartet minus one, maybe. There may be a duet minus one. We'll see who can show up with sickness and things going around. But go ahead and stand up. I'm going to send you out here in just a second. But the last announcement that I always give on Sunday morning before you go out the door is, if you brought your offering with you this morning and you have not gotten by the offering box is right there as you go out the door this morning. Thank you all for being here this morning. We'll send you out with Joy to the World. So if you want to sing along, feel free. But God bless you. See you later this afternoon. And joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King.
and nature sing, in heaven and nature sing, in heaven.